Good morning, everyone. My name is Luis Aguilar from Instituto Politécnico Nacional in Tijuana, Mexico. I'm going to present two relay controller and its application in snake-like rock motion and infinite dimensional setting. The outline of this presentation is I'm going to introduce the motivation, then I'm going to define the problem statement. I'm going to explain about the cell oscillation via two relay controller. Then I'm going to set conditions of the stability analysis by means of a strict Lyapunov function. Finally, I'm going to present some simulation and conclusion and future research works. Snakes are fascinating animals that can move through different surfaces, can swim, even they can fly. For these results, the scientist community has been motivated to design and build robotic snakes for exploration and risk purposes. This work is motivated for this motion, which is known as undulation. A study made by Bruce Jane and from the University of Cincinnati revealed that the displacement of a snake in a roof surface underwater in the water is produced by its wave motion, which is manifested by undulation of its body. Snake-like robots are constituted by multiple chains of links and joints. The forward displacement is induced through the coordinated motion of each actuator and joint. Different research groups have contributed on robotic snakes from different approaches. For example, I can mention from the group of the Norwegian University of Science and Technology to the work of Liedebach, Professor Peterson, Professor Stadtal, and Professor Grabstahl. Of course, a group of Japan developing the HiPod, and finally, people from biology who studied the motion of the locomotion of snakes, for example, the work of Williams, from one century ago about experiments on the snake locomotion. And another example is the work of Professor Jopkins, Planckin, and Professor Gupta. Usually the equation of motion of a snake is modeled as an ordinary differential equation from Euler-Lagrange approach, to mention only one. The contribution of is the generation of cell oscillation for a snake robotic system governed by a partial differential equation. We model the snake robot as an hyperbolic partial differential equation derived from the standard Hamilton principle. A boundary two-relay controller was used to induce self-oscillation in a snake-like robot, or that we know the undulation. But what about the two-relay controller? It's a method proposed by Professor Igor Boyko, Leonard Freeman, Rafael Irarte, and myself in order to induce self-oscillation in a non-minimal phase under actuated systems. So the methodology we propose is summarized as follows. We model a snake robot as a hyperbolic partial differential equation derived from the standard Hamilton principle. This work constitutes a first step in using the two-relay controller for an infinite dimensional system. The boundary controller is conformed by the stabilizing part and the cell oscillation generator part. The tuning of the two-relay controller is based on the frequency domain approach made for ordinary differential equations. Now, I'm going to talk about the two-relay controller. The two-relay controller is used to generate cell oscillations. These block diagrams illustrate the difference between the tracking controller and the cell oscillation controller. In the first one, the controller enforces that the output track the reference signal. In the other hand, the cell oscillation loop, we don't have a reference input, but the controller KY enforces the output to be periodic. Here, KY is the two-relay controller. The two-relay controller consists of two discontinuous functions in terms of the output as its time derivatives with constants C1 and C2 used to tune the frequency and amplitude of the signal. Notice that the two-relay controller is similar to the twisting controller. However, C1 and C2 can be any real number. For the twisting controller, C1 must be larger than C2. How can we prove the existence of a periodic solution? The simple way that we use was by means of the discriminant function method. However, we have results by Poincaré maps, but we don't want to talk about it in this presentation. According to the discriminant function method, there exists a periodic solution if the Nyquist plot intersects the discriminant function approach. That means if this inequality holds. If this inequality holds, then there exists a periodic motion with certain frequency amplitude A1 and a frequency omega. The Nyquist plot and the discriminant function method. If the intersection exists, then there exists a periodic solution. Then finally, after some simplification, we obtain a formula of C1 and C2 in order to set a desired frequency and amplitude. Here we have C1 in terms of the desired amplitude and desired frequency. Here C is the relation between the imaginary part of the transfer fusion and the real part of the transfer fusions. In this slide, the idea of this matrix was to induce self-oscillation in a non-minimum phase under actuated systems. I said non-minimum phase system when the oscillations occur at the upright position of the and the equilibrium is unstable. Here I'm going to introduce a brief video showing the periodic motion in a car pendulum. So the idea is to translate this motion in a slick robotic systems. Inspired on several works of snake locomotion, we decided to apply the turtle control methods to a snake robotic system. Instead of dealing with an ordinary differential equation, I found easy to deal with an infinite dimensional one. First, we use the Hamilton principle to derive the dynamic model, which is governed by the relation 6, where Ek is the kinetic energy, Ep is the potential energy, Ew is the work, delta is the variational operator, and W is the transverse motion on the snake. We assume that the heat is x equal to 0. So here is the heat of the snake. The genetic energy, the potential energy, and the work are given by the following equations. Highlighting that m is the mass, and rho is the mass length ratio, and p is the tension distributed through the snake body, and ut is the control force. Putting all together, we obtain the following relation. So in which the hyperbolic partial differential equation is the dynamic of the snake represented as a string, in which the hyperbolic partial differential equation is the dynamics of the snake represented as a string equation with a free end and an actuation in the other end specified by the boundary conditions. The control objective is to design a turtle controller ut such that the displacement of the snake W has a periodic motion. The main result is summarized in this slide. Here, put all together, U bar is a turtle controller. Here, what is the dynamic model of the snake? And C1 and C2 are this solution. Now, for simplicity, we add a stability controller given in equation 14, providing inequalities 15 and distinct holes. The stability analysis is made without the Turing controller by proposing the Lyapunov functional satisfying the condition below. After developing the time derivative along the solution of the closed-loop systems, we have this condition. Equation ET. The analysis to compute C1 and C2 for orbit stability analysis is similar for the infinite dimensional system. The analysis to compute C1 and C2 for orbit stability analysis is similar for the finite dimensional system. I'm going to present simulation. In this slide, I define the parameters and values of C1 and C2 obtained and Q1 and Q2 satisfying the previous conditions. So here at the last right side, I have the solution. We have this periodic motion. We have X, the displacement, the time, and the magnitude. Here we have the transverse motion with respect to displacement. We note the displacement is like an undulation, so representing the motion of the snake. This study establishes the generation of self-oscillation to induce the forward motion of a snake robot. The robotic system is modeled as an infinite dimensional system instead of multiple chains or links being a more realistic scenario for certain snakes. The controller consists of a stabilizing part and a self-oscillation part. The asymptotic stability of the former is verified by means of a strict Lyapunov function. The proposed controller ensures the asymptotic stabilization of the closed loop system, while the role of the Turing leg is to induce the periodic motion. This study constitutes the first step in applying the Turing leg controller in an infinite dimensional system. The implementation of the Turing leg controller constitutes a challenge, at least for medium or high-length snake-like robots. Significant problems exist to be considered as the input to state stability analysis, which is also an open topic for this two-way parameter system, and the orbital stability analysis of the boundary to random controller. The output of the case is also received for future research. Combining the two relay controllers with system governed by partial differential equation motivates its use in the solution of beyond spire and biological systems. Thank you. And this is my email for contact or questions.